Rectangle to a heart. One more time.
Take two.
Hi everyone, it's Chloe from Wondershare for more here to empower your inner video creator. Today, we are going to introduce a new host to our channel. Say hello to Aria.
Hello.
Let us know a little about yourself.
Well, I'm a videographer, photographer, editor. Yeah, that's about it.
All right, welcome to the channel and welcome to another episode of You Ask, We Answer. This is a series of us answering your questions that you left in the comments. So, as always, let's pull out the red bag and see what questions we have for this episode. The first one is from Andy Smith. A tutorial on what to do with the data after a video is completed would be great. What do I save and what can I delete? Recommendations on data content storage and organization would be appreciated. This was also the question I had when I first started.
We all have very different ways of doing it.
Yes.
But you and I actually have pretty similar ways because we work on the same team.
Yes. First thing first, make sure you create folders for each category of the media. Keep everything in one folder, right? And that will make backing up anything a lot easier. I don't delete anything personally. I will create another folder called ditched files and put anything that I did not use in the file. And still I'll back up the whole project file with that folder. So with all of that premise, when we finish the project, what I do is to zip the folder, the main folder, and back it up on my hard drive. And also for us, another thing that we do is to back up another copy on our server because we are a team. So whenever we want to access someone's project, it'll be great if we have a copy on server. And next question. Okay, who is this?
So this question is from Scott Peischer or Peischer. If you guys can do an entire series on B-roll, how to film it, what to film for your particular topic, and how to integrate it, that would be awesome. But first, we should mention what is B-roll. The thing about B-roll is that it's the footage you cut away to from the main footage. So you'll have the footage of someone talking, and then you'll go to other footage of something else going on.
This is also how we do for Filmora videos on our channel. We will write a script before filming to make sure that we have all the content.
The best part about that is you can go through your script and decide what is going to be your main footage and where can you put B-roll in, and you know it in advance, so it makes it easier to film on the day of. For example, you just saw some B-roll of me writing a script for a video for the Filmora channel. That is B-roll. The key about B-roll though, something we need to remember, is that the B-roll footage should still be related to your main footage. It should match the theme, it should match the genre. So, while we're on that note, we actually want to know, are there any particular genres of videos you guys are making nowadays? Let us know in the comments.
Next question. This question is from Darren Kellerman. Many of us use our phones to record. Any recommendations? I carry a phone instead of camera because it's so light and so easy to carry, you know? Just grab your phone, put it in your pocket. For my first tip, I would recommend going for a horizontal frame. because it looks more cinematic to me. I'm not sure how you feel about it.
Well, it really depends where you're posting your video. If it's on TikTok or an Instagram reel, you're gonna need to do it vertically.
So the second tip from me is to use a tripod with you while filming. Or if you don't have a tripod, lean it to a surface that is stable or steady. I think you can get a very similar shot.
Do you have anything weirder than that you use for a tripod?
So, I taped a phone on a tree before, and it was working pretty fine. If you want to try, I would suggest starting from your window. And the last tip for today could apply to all kinds of cameras, but I'm mentioning for a mobile phone because most likely we're filming under natural light. What we do is to make sure the sunlight or natural light is hitting on the far side of the subject instead of the near side. For me, it also looks more cinematic.
Yeah, we also did a video a few months ago on filming outdoors, especially in sunlight. So definitely go check that out.
All right, let's go to the next question and also the last question for today.
From Siba Dutta, filmmaking series, everything from top to bottom. It's quite broad. There's a lot of things in the film and video world that we could talk about.
Yeah, it includes producing, directing, cinematography, production design, which is more like set decoration, and acting? Also post-production. I would definitely want to know which part you like better, so we can probably make more videos about that for you. All right, those are all the questions that we have today for You Ask, We Answer episode 27. I'll make sure if you have more questions, drop them in the comments. We would love to read them and try to make more videos about them.
Thanks so much for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe for future videos on the channel. Keep creating, and we'll see you later.
Bye!